With the recent news dominated by information regarding recent coronavirus outbreak, I wanted to make a very simple presentation on how viruses use our cells to replicate themselves. So let's assume here that what we see is a very simple schematic representing our cell with the black circle with the DNA molecule inside representing cell nucleus. Inside the nucleus is the human genome, or the DNA, entire human DNA. And think of the DNA as a filing cabinet that will generate all the blueprints that are then subsequently used by the cell to create all the components of the cell. So DNA can generate these blueprints, which we call RNAs. And it is the RNAs that are then used to create all the different robots that do all the function inside the cell or components that make up the cell. And it is also a very specific little molecular robot that will do this function. It's called RNA polymerase, and RNA polymerase will attach to RNA and create specific products stemming from these RNAs. Sometimes you can have a mutation inside your DNA which will result in malfunction in one of these molecular robots. And this is how you can translate mutation in a DNA to broken molecular product, which at times can result in something as dramatic as a disease. Now let's focus on the virus itself. And here comes a virus particle on the left-hand side of the screen. So in order for viruses to enter our cells, they have to attach themselves to some type of specific receptor. Upon binding to a receptor on the surface of our cells, viruses can then enter our cellular environment. And once within the cell, viruses can then hijack our own mechanisms that our cells use to translate RNA blueprint to produce some specific product to produce viral specific product. But unlike what we do within our cells, viruses, their RNAs have to contain all of the information that a virus will require to replicate. So in this case, the product is something very big, and when our RNA polymerases translate the RNA, the product is usually a large chimera of fused molecular robots together. One of these subcomponents will be a robot that can cleave these apart, and once it's cleaved, we have multiple different products. One of these is a little molecular robot that can then make numerous copies of the RNA genome. And this is how virus genomes can be replicated. And what we see here represented as black circle, those will be the components required to make a viral envelope. And at that point, viral particles are complete and can exit the cell. In a process, they will usually kill the cell because they will puncture the membrane, or if you can think of it like the skin of the cell, and damage the cell. And subsequently, these viral particles can go on and infect additional cells within our body. And that's how virus can spread from cell to cell, as well as from host to host.